In this video, we will show how to disassemble cylinders and pistons. We will show the commonly used method, where the cylinder is disassembled first, and then the piston is removed from the connecting rod. But you can also disassemble the cylinder together with the piston, as one unit. It will become clearer later when to use which method. But first, we show the parts we will disassemble. In the middle is the cylinder. Inside the cylinder, slides the piston with its three piston rings. The piston is attached to the connecting rod by a piston pin or wrist pin. The piston pin slides through the piston and connecting rod and is secured with two circlips. The connecting rod will remain mounted for now. We will not disassemble it until the crankcase is split. In the previous videos of this series, we disassembled and reassembled the cylinder heads. While unscrewing the nuts of the cylinder heads, the gasket between cylinder and engine crankcase will always loosen slightly. This will result in oil leaks between cylinder and crankcase, which is not desirable. Therefore, we always recommend disassembling the cylinders as well and fitting them with new gaskets. Disassembling the cylinders and pistons is covered in this video. Here we show our AB1300 engine hanging from the engine mount. But you can also disassemble the cylinders and pistons with the engine on the workbench. This does not require the engine to be additionally secured to the workbench. Here you see the same engine on the workbench during its first overhaul. It is useful to leave the flywheel mounted as long as possible to be able to turn the crankshaft around. We use a socket wrench on the flywheel nut, but you can also just turn the flywheel with your hands. The back pressure on the flywheel should be minimal now that the cylinder heads have been removed. Be careful while turning the flywheel and tilting the engine. The gasket between cylinder and crankcase could come loose due to the friction of the piston rings against the cylinder wall. You can see that here, cylinder 4 slides over the threaded rods and threatens to come completely loose. If you are not careful, the cylinder could fall to the ground. Therefore, always use at least one nut on one threaded rod of each cylinder. If a cylinder does come loose, or you turn the engine mount around, the cylinder has nowhere to go. Once a cylinder is disassembled, you should also carefully guide the pistons while turning the flywheel. These could push against the crankcase and cause damage to various engine parts. Protect the piston rings if you want to reuse the piston. But it is just this protection that can cause damage while turning the flywheel. So, before you spin the flywheel, and thus the crankshaft, think twice, look carefully for any parts that may jam. If the engine has not run for a long time, the cylinders have probably dried up. With the piston at its bottom dead center, smear a little assembly grease against the wall of the cylinders. You may also use engine oil, but it, unlike assembly grease, will disappear quickly. Don't forget to remove the cooling air plate before pulling off the cylinders. This plate is attached to the threaded rods with some spring force. It does not matter which cylinder you disassemble first, we will start with cylinder 1. With the socket wrench on the flywheel, we can move the piston of cylinder 1 to the bottom dead center. With the piston in this position, the cylinder will offer less resistance. With some luck, the cylinder will come loose by pulling it firmly. If no movement is detectable, you will have to knock the cylinder loose. Use a rubber mallet. Tap gently against the cooling fins, longitudinally. Never tap crosswise against the cooling fins, you might break them. The cylinders are sealed to the crankcase with liquid gasket. This sometimes makes it difficult to pull the cylinders loose. On a high mileage engine, the cylinder will have seized up in the crankcase, which adds to the resistance. Remove the safety nut from the threaded rod. Note: if you are working with an engine mount, tilt the crankcase so that the cylinder cannot fall. When you feel the cylinder come loose, support the piston to avoid damaging the piston and piston rings. The cylinder may now be slid over the threaded rods. Turn the flywheel to position the piston at its top dead center. In this position, the piston pin is more accessible. Guide the piston by hand to avoid damage. The piston could jam against the crankcase, or the piston rings could be damaged. The circlip on this engine is of this type. This circlip has a convenient shape that allows you to push it loose with any long-jawed gripping pliers. You may also encounter this type of circlip. To grab these, you will need special circlip pliers. In video 19, we will discuss piston pin disassembly in detail. Grasp the circlip that holds the piston pin in place. You only need to remove one circlip for now, choose the one that is most accessible. The circlip tends to pop off, as we saw here. Use a cloth to cover the openings in the crankcase, if you do not plan to split the crankcase. There is a good chance that the circlip will fall into the crankcase, or jumping out very far, farther than you would think. You usually don't find it until a few days later, in the most unexpected place. Before you push the circlip in, protect it from jumping away using a cloth. A small effort to avoid many hours of searching. Before disassembling the piston of cylinder 1, we show the second method. This method, among others, is used when you only want to replace the gasket between the cylinders and the crankcase. In this second method, the cylinder, together with the piston, is disassembled as one whole. This way you leave the piston rings alone. We show this method on cylinder 2. With the piston of cylinder 2 in its lower dead center, loosen the gasket between cylinder and engine crankcase. Loosen the safety nut on the threaded rod. You will pull the cylinder over the rods until the piston pin is visible, but make sure the piston rings remain in the cylinder. Turn the flywheel until the piston pin is easily accessible to release the circlip. In doing so, guide the movement of the cylinder with its piston as one unit. Pull the cylinder further over the piston until the piston pin with its circlip is easily accessible. Remove the circlip. The piston pin can now be pushed out of the piston. We use a drift punch with a small hammer to do this. Push the piston pin out of the piston. Past the connecting rod, the piston pin may remain in the piston. The connecting rod will fall into the piston, when the piston pin is pushed far enough. Now the cylinder, with its piston, as one unit, can be disassembled. Hold the connecting rod so that it does not fall against the edge of the crankcase. As you can see here, with this second method, the piston and cylinder are disassembled as one unit. This will make assembly a lot easier later on. Because the piston pin is sometimes difficult to disassemble, we have made a separate video about this. In video 19, we will explain in detail how to disassemble a piston pin in any situation without damaging the engine parts. Now we still need to disassemble the piston of cylinder 1. With the circlip already removed on one side, push the piston pin loose until the piston detaches from the connecting rod. While holding the connecting rod, remove the piston. Remember to number all parts, or keep them together, in case you want to reuse them later. We still have to disassemble cylinders 3 and 4, and we are ready. We conclude this video with footage of the first overhaul of this AB1300 engine. Here we are working with the crankcase on the workbench. The cooling air plate is removed. Cylinder 1 comes off very easily, not much remains of the gasket between cylinder and crankcase. The piston rings will have to be replaced, no need to give them extra protection. Cylinder 2 also comes off very easily. During diagnosis, we will find that all cylinders were too affected to be reused. On cylinder 4, the piston rings are very tight in the cylinder, this is due to excessive corrosion. Cylinder 3 is very tight against the crankcase. This is the cylinder that takes up the most heat on these types of engines. The piston rings of this cylinder are very corroded. With short tilt movements of the cylinder, it comes loose after a while. We remove both circlips and disassemble the piston of cylinder 1. The piston pin cannot come out manually, the help of a drift punch with a hammer is needed. This can be done if the piston pin is not very tight. If the piston pin is too tight, use the tool we show in video 19. We will discuss the diagnosis of the cylinders, the piston and piston rings, the piston pin, in our other video series, which deals with type 1 engine diagnosis. In the next video, we will explain in detail how to disassemble a piston pin without force, and therefore without damaging the engine parts in any situation. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon.